The Treaty of Lisbon has been a major breakthrough for children and for UNICEF. And I envisage a relationship that would evolve from what had been essentially a contracting donor relationship to one of a full-blown partnership where we will be able to engage the EU on child rights issues, human rights programming, on policy, program innovation, field-level coordination in support of development policy and humanitarian action. This is because we now have in the EU a relationship of partner of choice, a privileged relationship both ways, in which we can bring a lot of our field expertise and global outreach to the policy and program and humanitarian work that they do. And we can benefit from their new focus on human rights and the rights of children. I think it's a huge opportunity for us because it allows a point of convergence between our leadership agenda on equity, which is essentially focusing everything that UNICEF does on the neediest and most disadvantaged children worldwide in all country contexts, as well as working with the EU to really bring to the fore the advocacy for rights-based programming and development work, doing the right thing both in principle and also in practice. So it's going to transform our relationship into a partnership based on values. I suspect that we're going to see synergies emerge. And I would like to call on UNICEF representatives, particularly at the field level, to do their best to reach out to the commissioners and the European Union and the European Commission at field level and help build the bridge between ourselves, national development partners, governments, and non-governmental organizations to see if we can maximize the reach of our programs and move development funding from Europe to support the neediest countries and the neediest children.